For this session, and you know, I read about excellence in action. The first part was what am I going to speak about? What do I say? I don't come from a very specific function like quality, where I can you know have some very nice slides and talk about things that I have done. So the word that came to my mind is about action, because that's what all my 13 years, that's what I have been asked to do is, words are fine, you come from a very nice institute where you have made this very nice PPTs and you learnt on this nice jargon, and unlike you, I was a fresher when I joined my MBA, so I had absolutely no idea how industry works, and so I had these grandiose theories, and within my batch, there were people who had come with 3 years, 5 years experience, and they would really laugh at certain things that we freshers would come up and say. You know, freshers have this uncanny ability of coming up with really funny things about how business should be done. So that's where we started off from. I'm pressing too hard. So these are the things that. This is the reason why I chose we might be working for an organization, or we might be working for a customer, or we might even be entrepreneurs and working for ourselves, but ultimately what we do has an intense personal angle to it. You need to get in touch with yourself and find out what is that personal motivation, purpose, value in life, higher calling, whatever you want to whatever fancy name you want to put, I call it purpose. Whatever it is, you need to find that personal purpose for working. I work because I need the money. I work because I enjoy certain aspects of the job I do. I work because it's the easiest thing for me since I've been doing all this for a long time, it's quite easy. Then comes your organization's purpose.
Because I know it's a very small time of, let's say in terms of the span, you'll be tracking for maybe 30-40 minutes, right? So whenever you are, let's say, getting out of touch in terms of what I am talking or what I am speaking about, please let me know, right? Great. So we always talk about quality. Can anyone tell me that? What is the importance of quality? Why do we always talk about quality?
Constantly improving the performance.
Why that is needed?
To achieve the main goal
for customer satisfaction.
For customer satisfaction. Yeah, you are right. I just keep the basic size at this point of time when we start the session. What are the aim of the organizations or aim of any business organizations when they are doing business? What is their primary objective?
Getting higher profit and lower cost.
Exactly. Earning profit. That's the basic thing. And what is the basic concept of earning more profit? How you can do that?
Selling more and optimize.
Selling more.
Selling more.
So there are vendors, champions, sponsors. So this kind of framework you need to have. Without that, you cannot start implementing this kind of driving itself. Right? So that's sometimes lack of basics, most of the organizations they fail implementing Six Sigma. They'll come back and say that okay, Lean Six Sigma doesn't work for me. Lean Six Sigma, I have seen that people will say that Lean Six Sigma doesn't work for my kind of organization or my kind of industry, it is not implemented. It is only for the manufacturing area. Have you come across this kind of scenario? It's only for manufacturing.
Yeah.
You have heard the story of G, right? Jaguar and G.
Yeah.
Right. One good thing happened with GE is when they were evolving the Six Sigma throughout there, they have tested it throughout different industry verticals. GE is the most versatile business outfit. Yeah. They are present in everywhere. Right? Manufacturing there, financial services there, IT
there.
Healthcare. They are everywhere. So they have what good thing they have done so that we are not going and reinventing this. They have tested Six Sigma, Lean, throughout all the verticals of their business. So that's why we can say it is implemented. Only thing is that how you are implementing, that is important. So the first challenge you will be facing while you are going and implementing this kind of business excellence program is lack of basics. Next is alignment with the business goal. At the very beginning, I have started with that why you are focusing on quality is nothing but my objective is to maximize my profit, right? So if your business...
When you don't start working, how do you gather the experience? And now if all employers say, okay, we need experienced people, so we will go into unemployment.
So it's
separate example.
Chicken or egg.
Yeah. At some point, doesn't it make sense to get, I mean, the key factor is the aptitude of understanding and to train them?
I completely agree with you. What happens is, what is the major difference between different resources you work with in that? How quickly I can learn.
Right.
Most of the times it happens that I was telling you that vintage is not equivalent to maturity always. Right? I might have 5 years of experience, but a 5 months experienced guy might know many more things than me. Right? So what happens to you, how we start is, because when you are running a business excellence team, you will have, let's say, depending on the size of the organization, maybe 20, 30, 40 member team will be running. Right? And all those team members will be, let's say, minimum of 4 years, 5 years of experience. Right? You, typically, in this kind of function, there is no freshers who join from the college after doing graduation. Why? Because there is a need. Because you will be leading a team when you are running a project. You will be working as a mentor, you will be working as a project lead. So how do you do it in terms of getting resources, competent resources, who can mentor others? Who can drive this initiative, that first you go and work in projects as a project leader, as a project manager within the organization. So there is a concept called functional blindness. There is a concept called functional greenness. What they do, they have a day job in terms of, let's say, I'm part of marketing, I'm part of finance, I'm part of research and development team. I have a day job. Along with that, I will lead a particular project, gather experience while I'm doing that project, and then gradually I will build myself on that I can go and mentor others. Right? So most of the times we do not prefer that with 2 years of experience or maybe a fresher, maybe
a fight with your boss. So sometimes to vent out your frustration, you say all these things in front of your team. It never pays. Because that whole thing will bounce back on you one day. So don't ever do this. But yes, your team must also feel that their issues are taken up firmly with your boss. If you don't do that, then you're not a leader. Never fire your teammates in front of your boss. Many people do that. You know, when you go for a visit and the team is sitting, the boss of that place will fire somebody in front of his senior. That's the most hurting thing that you can do to anybody. You want to fire your teammates? Do it in closed rooms. Never pull up your teammates in front of each other. It hurts their ego. Don't ever hurt their ego, they'll never perform. Praise people in open forums, of course, this is a well-known fact. Be punctual at work and with clients. Be part of the solution rather than a problem. Whenever you go to your boss with a problem, go with an alternate solution. Your boss will always appreciate it. If you are always a guy who goes with a problem to your boss, you will never get appreciated. You will never ever be a good person. And then you also not try to find a solution. I've always appreciated people who will come with a problem with an alternate solution.